बिस्मिल्लाहिर्रहमानिर्रहीम, अस्सलाम वालेकुम डियर स्टूडेंट्स। वी आर स्टडीइंग द न्यू सिलेबस मैथमेटिक्स, इट्स बुक 2 एंड इट्स चैप्टर नंबर 3। टुडे इज आवर लास्ट लेसन ऑफ चैप्टर नंबर 3 एंड दिस इज लेसन नंबर 17 इन विच वी विल स्टडी फैक्टराइजेशन ऑफ क्वाड्रेटिक एक्सप्रेशन। This is what we have studied in the previous lessons. Method for factoring quadratic expression. These are the steps. You know these steps very well. And signs of two factors of this number a. The rule one is if a is plus, then factors will be either plus or minus. B, if b is plus, then factors are both plus. If b is minus, then factors are both minus. In case a is plus, and if a is minus, then both the factors will be of different signs. If b is plus, then larger will be plus and smaller will be minus, and if b is minus, then larger will be minus and smaller will be plus. So these are the rules which we have studied, and we have solved many questions using these two rules. Now let's solve some more questions of exercise 3b. Now let's solve some questions of exercise 3b. This is question number 3. In this question, it is asked that factorize each of the following expressions completely. A part, it is minus a square plus 2a plus 35. The method is same. We will multiply the coefficient of a square with the constant terms. Coefficient of a square is minus 1. So minus 1 multiplied by plus 35 is minus 35. Now because this number is negative and this number is positive, because this number is negative, so the two factors will have different signs. Larger will have positive sign and smaller will have negative sign. These are two factors, minus 5 and plus 35. So what are the two factors which when multiplied give you minus 35, and when you add those two factors give you plus 2, so it is minus 5 and plus 7. When you will add these two numbers, you will get plus 2, and when you will multiply these two numbers, you will get minus 35. It is this, minus a square and minus 5a plus 7a. We will break this middle terms and we will write minus 5a plus 7a. Now from the first two terms, we will take out the minus a common, and we are left with the a plus. When we take minus common, the sign within the bracket changes. It is 5, then plus 7 common, and we are left with a plus 5. Now the factor within the bracket is same or common. We will take this out, common, a plus 5, and from this term minus a, and from this plus 7. So these are the two factors. This is D part. Now look, this is a slightly different from this question. In this question, there is common in all the three terms. 5 is common in all the three terms. So first we will take this out common, which will make our factorization easy. When we take 5 common from all the terms, we get b square minus 29b plus 120, dividing 145 by 5 and 600 by 5 gives you 120 and minus 29. Now this is the expression of this type, and we will factorize this expression within the bracket by using the same method. Multiply with the coefficient of d square with this constant term, you will get plus 125. Now because this number is plus, so both the factors will be negative, because the sign of the middle term is negative. So the two factors of this number are minus 1, minus 21, minus 2, minus 60, minus 3, plus minus 4, 40, minus 4, minus 30, minus 5, minus 30, 24, minus 6, minus 20, and minus 8, minus 15, minus 10, minus 12. So what are the two factors which when multiply gives you 125, and when you add gives you या माइनस 29, सो दे आर माइनस 5 एंड 24. देन यू विल ऐड दीज टू फैक्टर्स, यू विल गेट माइनस 29 एंड देन यू विल मल्टीप्लाई दीज टू, यू विल गेट प्लस 120. सो ब्रेक द मिडिल टर्म, कीप 5 आउटसाइड द ब्रैकेट. डी स्क्वायर माइनस 5 डी माइनस 24 डी प्लस 120. Now from these two terms d is common. Take d common and we are left with d minus 5. Minus 24 is common and in the bracket we are left with d minus 5. Now from these two terms d minus 5 is common. 5 which is outside the bracket, d minus 5 this and d minus 24 from this term and this term. So these are the factors and we are able to complete factorize this expression like this. It's g power. It is 30 plus 14k minus 4kk. Again, from all these three numbers, there is a number which is common in all the three numbers, three terms, and that number is 2. 2 divides 30, 14, and 4 at the same time. So we will take 2 common from all these terms. 15 plus 7k minus 2k square. Same, we will multiply this constant term with the coefficient of x k square, which is minus 2. Minus 2 multiplied by 15 gives you minus 30. Now, because this is negative, so the signs of the two factors will be different. One will be negative, another will be positive. Which will be positive? The larger one will be positive because the sign of the middle term is positive. So it is minus 1 plus 30, minus 2 plus 15, minus 3 plus 10, minus 5 plus 6. These are the factors of 30. Now what are the two factors which when multiply give you minus 30 and when you add gives you 7? So it is minus 3 and 10. So we will break this middle term. 2 as it is plus 15 plus 7 can be written as minus 3k plus 10k minus 2k square. Now we will take a number common from the first two terms, which is 3. 5 minus k within the bracket, from here 2k is common plus 2k. So dividing 10k by 2k we get 5, and 2k square divided by 2k gives you minus k. Now this 5 minus k is common within the brackets. So 2 which is outside the bracket, 5 minus k, this is common in these two terms, and from this term we are left with 3, and from this term we are left with 2k. So these are the factors: 2, 5 minus k, 3 plus 2k. H part. In this part again there is something common in all the three terms, and that common is 5n. 35 is divided by 5, n is there, n is there, and n is there. So we will take this out. 5 can also be divided by 5 and 30 can also be divided by 5. So we are left with 7m square plus m minus 6 inside the bracket. Now this expression is quadratic expression. We will multiply the coefficient of m square by the constant term, and this will give us minus 42. Now because this is negative, so two factors will have different signs. Because the middle term is positive, the sign of the larger will be positive. Minus 1 plus 42, minus 2 plus 21, minus 3 plus 14, minus 6 plus 7. Now what are the two factors which when multiply give you minus 42 and when you add give you plus 1? So it is minus 6 and plus 7. These two factors, when you will add these two give you plus 1, and when you will multiply it, this will give you minus 42. So break the middle term and write 7m square plus 7m minus 6m minus 6. From these first two terms take something common, which is 7m. 5n, 7m, m plus 7, minus 6, m plus 1. here it will be m plus 1. 5n plus 5 m plus 1 and 7m minus 6 is the final factor of factorization of this expression. So this is question number 4. You are asked that the area of rectangle x square plus 8x plus 12 centimeter square. If the length of the rectangle is this and show that its breadth is this. Okay, आपको पता है कि एरिया क्या होता है, रेक्टेंगल का एरिया होता है लेंथ और ब्रेथ को मल्टीप्लाई करें तो एरिया आता है। अब उसने कहा है ये इसकी लेंथ दी हुई है और ये रेक्टेंगल दी हुई है, इसकी लेंथ दी हुई है सॉरी एरिया दिया हुआ है, शो करें कि उसकी ब्रेथ जो है या ब्रेथ वो x प्लस 2 है। तो इस एक्सप्रेशन को जो एरिया है उसको अगर हम फैक्टराइज करें और उसकी फैक्टराइजेशन इन दोनों के प्रोडक्ट के इक्वल आ जाती है, यानी लेंथ और ब्रेथ के प्रोडक्ट के इक्वल आती है, तो फिर इसका मतलब है उसकी ब्रेथ जो है वो ये वाला एक्सप्रेशन होगी। तो बिकॉज एरिया ऑफ द रेक्टेंगल इज इक्वल टू लेंथ इनटू ब्रेथ, एरिया इज गिवन व्हिच इज दिस एक्सप्रेशन, फैक्टराइज दिस एक्स स्क्वायर प्लस 2x प्लस 6x प्लस 12, बिकॉज प्लस 1 मल्टीप्लाइड बाय 12 गिव यू plus 12 and factor because this is plus, both the factors will have same sign and because this sign is plus so both will be positive, 1 and 12, 2 and 6, 3 and 4. So what are two numbers which when added give you 8? It is 6 and 2. So we will break this middle term 8 by taking these two factors, 2x plus 6. Now from this we will take common. X is common, we are left with x plus 2, plus 6 is common, we are left with x plus 2. This is x plus 6 and x plus 2. Now this is the area, this is the length, so this what the second factor is the breadth, because length multiplied by breadth gives you the area of rectangle. So this is the breadth of rectangle. So we are able to prove that breadth of the rectangle is this if area is this and its length is this. Question number 5, factorize each of the following expressions completely. Now look here, the coefficient of the p square is a fraction. So first we will remove this fraction to factorize this expression. We will take the LCM of all or we will multiply each term by 9 to remove the fraction. So we will get 4p square plus 9p minus 9 over 9. So this expression in the numerator is a quadratic expression. We will factorize this expression and we will keep 9 as it is. 4 multiplied by minus 9 is minus 36. What will be the factors of minus 36? Because this number is negative, so both the factors will be of different signs. Because the sign of the middle term is positive, the larger factor will be positive. These are the factors of minus 36. So which are the two factors which when multiply gave you minus 36 and when you add those two factors gives you plus 9. Adding, these are the two factors, minus 3 and plus 3, these two. So break the middle term, 4p square minus 3p plus 12p minus 9 over 9. Similarly factorize first two and last two terms. From first two term p is common, we are left with 4p minus 3, and from 12p 3 is common, we are left with 4p minus 3. So within the bracket 4p minus 3 is same, we will take out this common and we will combine these two terms, p plus 3 over 9. So these are the factors of this expression. You can try these parts of question 3 and this part of question 5. Syllabus for your online assessment is chapter number 1 which is direct and inverse proportion and chapter number 3 which is expression and factorization quadratic expression of book D2. We have completed chapter number 3 after this lesson, and next we will start chapter number 4. This is my profile and my YouTube channel is this. Practice makes knowledge perfect. Thank you for watching and Allah Hafiz.